Hello everybody and welcome back to Chellington 17. So today is going to be a different episode because we're going to buy a mod. And this all, it doesn't totally stem from a particular comment, but I did have a comment yesterday, which was a bit of an eye-opener really. It said along the lines of, I'm trying to find it, but it said along the lines of your videos aren't very good or something because you don't use enough mods. And I do agree in some respects. So I'm going to take action on this and we are going to use more mods from now on because I think it does add a lot to the game, providing the mods I choose are of decent quality. So I did say we were going to buy a Land Rover. That is what we're going to do today. Not for the whole episode, obviously, just for the starting part. I don't think we're going to have a great deal to do with it today, but we're going to at least buy it. So in the car section, here it is, Land Rover Defender. It is by Adige Modding, and it is £28,499. You can indeed modify it. It doesn't cost any more. So you can have standard, or you can add the roll cage for no extra. Sounds like a pretty good deal to me. We obviously know somebody at the dealership. But yes, we're going to buy it. So there we go, with the roll cage. Don't like teleporting, but we are going to. Just this once, and here it is. The Land Rover Defender, with lots of detailing. Brilliant for off-road use. And yeah, I think it's going to be an interesting thing for our farm vehicle. This is going to be our main vehicle for getting about. It looks very cozy in there. Very well kitted out though. Highly detailed. So yes, without any further ado, let's begin. We'll start the engine and we will drive over to the farm. It's a nice ride. Just thinking of something. There was also a comment yesterday which said, don't forget to sell or return your leased item of a stump grinder. So we'll do that. There we go. It was in the grass in the forest, so it's gone now. Oh yeah, it's a nice vehicle. This is a perfect test for it. This bumpy track. So, do the indicators work? Yes, they do. And the lights? Yep, fantastic. I'm not sure if it's got IC. This is the first time I've ever used it. I don't think it does. No. But it doesn't really need it. It's good anyway. Okay, we're definitely feeling the bumps. It's not eliminating them. But I would say it is smoother than a tractor, and we are going faster. It's a pretty amazing mod. I'm going to enjoy using this. Anyway, before I crash, I will explain today's job. It was the winning vote from yesterday, and it is to do some cultivating and then some planting of either potatoes or sugar beet. So we need to obviously find a decent cultivator. I think we've got one, but if we don't, this could be a very costly video. Plus we need to also get a planter. I think we've got a seed drill, but not a planter. It depends what we're going to do, whether it's potatoes or sugar beet. To be honest, it doesn't bother me either way. Both are root crops and both can be used for the pigs. Pigs are going to be the only animals that we use on this Let's Play. We're not going to breed any others, just because we don't have time. There are so many maps out for FS. I need to keep doing different maps as well. But we are home. Here we are. The Defender is back. And yeah, I'm afraid that is going to be it for today from the Defender. It's going to be great for turning around the water bowser and stuff like that. I think I'm going to have to try and get a trailer for it too. Because it would be great for towing the skid steer loader. So, yeah, many uses there. Right, so, the cultivator. Oh, is that it? Oh, good. Well, our fields are pretty big. So, yeah. This may take some time. Let's take a look at the status of field number one, and then we'll go from there. The reason why is because that isn't quite as big. I'm not trying to go for the smallest, but even fear number one is big. So, the status of fear number one is ploughed, which means it does need to be cultivated and then, of course, planted. We don't necessarily have to cultivate it, but I think we will do just to create a decent seedbed. Although, if it's going to be potatoes, yeah, it still needs to be worked down a bit. It wouldn't feel right not breaking the soil down even slightly. So, yes, we're going to have to do a bit of selling. I think if we get rid of this plough and this cultivator, we should then be able to afford a larger cultivator. And then, of course, we need to be able to buy the planter. The planter is, where would it be? In cedars? Where is cedars? Sewing machines. Well, it depends what we're going to do. If it's potatoes, it's this one here, 21,000. We could rent it just for a day. Otherwise, it would be this one here. This one can do the sugar beet, which is considerably cheaper, just £13,000. So I think it is going to be sugar beet we do today, just to keep the costs down, as we only have 21,000 anyway. So we do have to be careful. Right, two tractors then. Two tractors are needed, the Massey Ferguson and the JCB. A lot of people have also noticed I use Massey Ferguson quite a bit. It's true, I like Massey Fergusons. I probably shouldn't use them quite as much. It's a bit of a habit. So I promise the next Let's Play I do, I'll try and calm down a bit. But for this one, we are going to have to keep it. It's a decent tractor. You can't argue against it. It just is. That's why I use it so much. You would have thought I worked for Massey Ferguson, but no, I don't. I'm just very positive about their stuff. Right, we need to put it into transport mode. There we go. That should be okay. We now need to get the JCB and attach that to the cultivator. The cultivator is very small. However, we are going to obviously need the tractors at the other end as well to then pick up the sowing machine or seed drill and also the cultivator. I think we are going to do this as a follow me job. It just depends on how similar the working width is. If the working width isn't the same, then it will be much tougher to do this, but all we can do is hope. I can look, obviously, which I will do because it's common sense to look first. The sewing machine is 3 meters. Not very big. I fear the cultivator may be quite a bit bigger than this because I want to go for something like this one here. It is 4.8 meters. So no, we won't be able to do it on Follow Me, but we will be able to do this on Follow Me. We drive to the shop. Obviously, I am leading. We'll put the beacons on just to warn the other traffic. And I will see you at the store. Now, I just want to discuss very quickly the sort of topic of replying to comments on YouTube videos. I know that some YouTubers can get a bit of a reputation for not replying because, well, a lot of viewers think they've just got to that stage where they're so big, they don't really care about what other people say. I don't reply that much, but I do read every comment which is published on a new video. So I do always take into consideration all of these suggestions. I do read the rude comments and I do read the positive comments, some of which are nice to read, some of which are pretty disgusting to read, but yeah, that is why I know that I do need to change something about the gameplay style here. I think a lot of the videos are starting to become a bit similar, so I am going to try and diversify what we do and make it a bit more interesting. And I have also decided, or hope I have decided, which map is going to be used in the multiplayer series. I'm hoping to use the FS09 map, which has been modified for 17, and then we'll be able to do that in multiplayer. I am, of course, going to get in touch with the author to make sure they're happy with it, but hopefully they will be. But I just think it's going to be a decent map. Oh, don't crash. I suppose that's another thing I need to work on as well. Think before you do stuff. It's actually pushed out of the box, but hopefully it's still going to read it. Yes, it is good. And that is pretty much £20,000. Not bad at all. It would be much nicer to buy this equipment than it would be to lease it. So if we can afford it and have enough cash left over, we'll buy them. That isn't quite as good, but it's obviously smaller. Right, so let's buy. We need to buy this one here. 23, actually, how much is this one here? Yeah, that's not a great deal of an upgrade, I suppose, for the price. It's not bad, but it could do better. I think we will go for this one. Otherwise, we're not going to be able to afford this. Actually, no, we would. Sorry, I'm just getting carried away here in my thoughts. I think, yes, we'll go with this one. What's this? I don't know what that does exactly. But I don't think we'll bother with it just yet. We'll keep it as it is. Standard. And then we'll buy our cedar. Sewing machine, and then this one here. I'm pretty sure we do own another one. Oh, we already do own it, you fool. What a fool. Well, that's good. That's brilliant. That means we're doing better than I actually thought. I don't know where it is, though. No, where could it be? I have no idea. Still, that is brilliant news. I should look into getting a manual attach as well. Do we need a rear front weight? I don't think we do. No, should be good. Right, so we're going to put the JCB back on to follow me. We're going to head back to the yard. We're going to pick up the cedar, which we apparently do own. And then we're going to begin. Really looking forward to this. Something which has crossed my mind is to do the field half and half. It's just that would be even more expensive because we have to get the potato planter as well. But it's not a bad idea, splitting a field in half. So half potatoes, half sugar beet. This is quite wide. Must be careful. Right, see you back at the farm. And we'll try and find the cedar. I bet it's not far away at all. So here we are, back at the farm. Thinking about it, I think I have seen it. It's, as far as I'm aware, down the bottom. I think I even looked at it yesterday. I just totally overlooked it for some strange reason. Anyway, you go there, and we'll jump into this tractor, and we'll pick it up. The lights are still on the Land Rover. Interesting. Yeah, I think it's down. Yes, there it is. I did see it yesterday. How weird. But yes, it isn't big. It's pretty small. And also, we're doing all this work to obviously get more money. But with the interactive series, which is going to be one map a week, obviously at the moment it's Chellington, we are going to transfer that money, which we created in the interactive series, to the next series. So on the next map, we'll have all the money from this map. So we sort of always get better. All of this work isn't for nothing. We're not just doing this let's play and then we start again, because that would be really boring. We do need to fill that up too. Mustn't forget. The seed refill point is there. Better do that. It's currently set to sunflowers. I'll change it to sugar beet. There we go. No, that's just corn. There we go. And fertilizer as well. That would be good. fertilizer is good. This thing can do it at the same time, so I think, if I remember where it is, we'll fill it up with fertilizer as well. Where is it? I've forgotten. Okay, so here is the fertilizer as well. Pretty expensive, but it's gonna be worth it. For once, we're gonna do a job properly. Off we go to fill number one. Too many lights, we've got every light on. That fertilizer cost £1,600. That is expensive. The first job which needs to be done is obviously the cultivating, then we'll do the seeding. That I think is the field. No, it's field number two. Field two is bigger. But yes, field number one is still pretty large. I think nearly every field on this map is large. With the equipment we have here, you wouldn't really want to do a bigger field with this stuff. I can remember harvesting this and it still took a while. Here we are. Right, yes, that is a large field. We'll stop that tractor there. I don't know if we'll get onto it today because it's a big job. But we'll definitely do the cultivating. The cultivator is a better width, but you're still not going to want to watch this. This is going to be quite a big job, actually. We should probably go with the furrow just because it's going to be a bit comfier. But it does go a funny way, so it'd be quite hard to. Turn the beacons off. We don't need to warn the birds that we're here. Also, turn our lights off again. Those lights keep turning on. It's when I stop the follow me. But yes, I'm going to get this job done. It is going to take a while. I was going to do a time-lapse, but I've just thought even a time-lapse would probably take a long time. Time-lapses need to be sort of a catchy length. They don't want to be too long, otherwise it can get a bit boring. So I could time-lapse a little bit of it. I'm going to carry on. I'm going to start. I'm going to carry on and do a bit, and then I do a time-lapse, and hopefully fairly soon we'll be done and then we'll be able to do the seeding. But I did tell you, these fields are not small. Okay then, so we have done quite a bit of the field here. There is a scarecrow in the field next to us. But yeah, we're very close to the end. The field actually gets narrower at this end, so it takes obviously less time to cultivate and seed. I did have an idea for the seeding, because it is a very small seeder, and we do need to get on with other jobs as well. What I could do is I could mark out the headland, and then the worker would be able to just get on with it on its own. Some people like it when I use a worker, some people don't. But I think if we were to use that 3-meter seeder in a video, it would take quite some time and it would probably take the entire video. So it would begin to get a bit boring. Although I obviously record doing the marking out. We wouldn't just have it where it's just suddenly, oh look, it's ready to harvest because it's been seeded off screen. We would obviously see some of the seeding process, but I think that is probably going to be the best thing to do. It's amazing, from up here, the view, you can even see the castle over there in field 18. Pretty good view. See that really big oilseed rape field as well, which we fertilised. At some point it might be a good idea to actually harvest that, as we did improve the productivity of it. Anyway, yes, very close to the end here. I'll obviously go around the headland and eaten up, and then it will be time to begin seeding. So the final corner of the field we have almost done. Matty Ferguson has of course performed effortlessly. Very good indeed. It probably should have had a front weight on. There is excessive wheel slip. You do need some wheel slip, but yeah, it's a bit excessive. There we go, and hopefully this will all fit in one go. Brilliant. I'll do a lap of the headland and then the cultivating is done. What is this anyway? Amazon Catros plus 6002-3, is it? Yeah, some of the model numbers are a bit confusing. It must be quite hard to think of them. It must be the working width, I suppose, which is incorporated into the number. I'm guessing. Not sure. Weird. Anyway, yes, let's just do this and then we'll mark out the seeder and let the worker get on with it. Good thing is, because we've got the fertiliser, we don't even have to do the first fertilising stage. It does it for us. I think something like a weeder would be quite good. I don't know if we can still use one if we've already fertilised it to begin with, because it does have to be done in the early stages of the crop being planted. But I think probably once the crop has germinated, it's the next growth stage, so it should recognise it as a different fertiliser layer. Using a weeder would be quite fun. We'll fold this up and park it up near the gate. And I think the best way to go with the worker would be lengthways. It doesn't have to turn around as much, and also there's less to hit. These workers do seem to be attracted to the trees. They crash into them most times. So I'm going to make it as easy as possible. Does this thing unfold? I think it's so small it doesn't even need to. It should be on our smaller voucher tractor. We're going to keep it very simple. We've got the right crop selected. Well, it's quite hard to see where we've been. But on the way back again, we'll set it off on the worker, and it should be clever enough to recognise where it is. If it isn't clever enough, then this may all go badly wrong. But fingers crossed it is going to work. The worker has improved dramatically since the earlier versions of the game, although I seem to always get lumbered with the bad workers for some weird reason. But still, maybe they'll be intelligent enough for this, I'm hoping. It's easier to see now where we've been. It's not too bad. Good. So we can go in cab view because we've got the marker down. Keep it aligned with the little notch in the front of the bonnet. I think it actually does depend on which country you're in as to where you line it up with. Some countries, I believe, the drills are designed to line it up with the wheel. but I think a lot of countries it's designed to line up with the centre of the bonnet, which is what we're doing at the moment. Anyway, that should be enough for it. Put it on a worker. You've absolute fool worker, where are you going? Yeah, these workers, they do not like it. You might have to bear with me. If the worker is going to decide where it's going to go, it obviously wants to go lengthways across the field that way. Seems like an odd idea, but maybe if we just let it do it, it will find it easy enough. Yeah, because some are set to go north to south and east to west, whereas this one seems to be determined to go just one way. Which is fine if it can do it, it's just I was trying to make it easy. Yeah, should be alright. Off you go then, worker. Let's hope you manage it okay. It's going to go straight through the middle of the field and then cut it in half. Brilliant logic there. I should have started it in that corner then, so it could work like this. And then it would end up over there. Anyway, with this large-ish job out of the way, we're going to conclude the video here. So thank you for watching. Please vote on what we're going to do tomorrow. And until then, see you again soon. Bye for now.